I wanted to set up a cybersecurity testing lab so that I can run some experiments. Enter stage left, Parallels. So in this video, I'm gonna teach you how to set up Windows on your Mac using Parallels so that you can run your mad scientist dreams and learn more about cybersecurity. Installing Parallels is super straightforward. All you have to do is head over to their website, and you'll see smack on their website, there's an option for Parallels Desktop for Mac. So just click on Download Free Trial. That's going to download an installer to your system. You're just gonna double click on that, and then you're gonna start that download process. Download the installer, give it a double click, and then read through all the legal jargon, and accept. Parallels is now going to download that to your system, and you can just finish the install. It's going to ask you to enable a bunch of permissions. This is useful if you're doing an integrated system, but less important and annoying if you're just trying to do this as an isolated lab, which I highly recommend. After Parallels finishes installing, it doesn't wait any time to ask you if you want to install Windows 11 on your system. You don't have to do this right away. If you did want to install another virtual machine like a Kali Linux or a other Linux distro of your flavor, you can go ahead and do that. For our purposes, I'm gonna go ahead and install the Windows 11 option because I wanna test being able to run Windows malware on the system. Keep in mind here that it is going to require that you have a valid Windows license, so it's gonna cost you a little bit of extra money here to keep this legitimate. Installing Windows is as straightforward as installing Parallels. It's just going to ask you if you want to install Windows, and then you click Install Windows, and Parallels will take care of the rest. So we're gonna wait a little bit longer here just to let Windows download to the system, and then we'll get on with it. Once Windows does download to your system, it's going to ask you if you want to allow additional permissions to it. Just go ahead and disallow this here. The whole point of this is that we're trying to keep this isolated, so we don't want to share permissions that we're never going to intend to use in the first place. And then we wait again. At this point, you're going to have to create a Parallels account. If you're doing the free trial now, it will prompt you if you want to buy it. You can just extend that trial out and just wait for as long as you possibly can, and then you will have to buy a license to continue to use Parallels. Once you create the account, it's going to ask you to read the privacy policy, which I definitely did, and then you can click through that. And then you're gonna get the Windows license agreement, which I also definitely read, and then you can click through that as well. Now it's time to isolate the VM. Again, this means that we're preventing the VM from interacting with our host system, which in this case is our Mac, to keep things separate and clean. You do this by opening up the settings, going over to the security tab, and then selecting isolate Windows from my Mac. You'll need to sign out and in again after that for it to take effect. Now, the main reason I wanted to go with the updated license for Parallels is because it allowed me to get snapshots. This is a must for when you're playing around with malware because you need to be able to get that system back to a known good state. Snapshots are essentially a picture in time of that system. It's going to take a picture of all of the different configurations and settings and files so that when you need to, it can revert back to that known good state. To create your first snapshot, simply go to Actions, take a snapshot, enter some details, and then click OK. You'll then see the snapshots by clicking on Manage Snapshots. At any time, you can go back and just revert back to a previous snapshot to pick up where you left off. If you haven't subscribed to the channel yet, do that now because we're gonna be doing a bunch of experiments in this VM and you can follow along with me. All right, we'll see you then.